Chapter 10. Stuck Fast. The day was nearly gone when at last the raft was ready.
"It ain't so very big," said the old sailor, "but I don't weigh much, and you, Trot, don't weigh half as much as I do, and the glass pussy don't count."
"But it's safe, isn't it?" inquired the girl.
"Yes, it's good enough to carry us to the island and back again, and that's about all we can expect of it."
Saying this, Captain Bill pushed the raft into the water, and when it was afloat, stepped upon it and held out his hand to Trot, who quickly followed him. The glass cat boarded the raft last of all. The sailor had cut a long pole, and had also whittled a flat paddle, and with these he easily propelled the raft across the river. As they approached the island, the wonderful flower became more plainly visible, and they quickly decided that the glass cat had not praised it too highly. The colors of the flowers that bloomed in quick succession were strikingly bright and beautiful, and the shapes of the blossoms were varied and curious. Indeed, they did not resemble ordinary flowers at all. So intently did Trot and Cap'n Bill gaze upon the golden flower pot that held the magic flower that they scarcely noticed the island itself until the raft beached upon its sands. But then the girl exclaimed,
"How funny it is, Cap'n Bill, that nothing else grows here except the magic flower."
Then the sailor glanced at the island and saw that it was all bare ground, without a weed, a stone, or a blade of grass.